Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness. And all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice. Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't.
Just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Senua never could close her eyes. However hard she tried. Begged. Into the relentless darkness. All that lurks within it can see you too.
Illusion comes from ravens. Align the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth. Look how much has changed.
moving into another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching. Another gate.
Another gate. You know what to do.
Stay back.
You have to open it.
It's not safe. Don't
to break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see them? Align up the ravens.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, and his brains clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from missable and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as wards.
She can get up now.
What's happening?
She can get up now.
How can she get up?
It
must be magic.
Dark magic.
A trick. Valravan.
Tricking her.
Valravan.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not. He's helping her. It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her. It's magic.
It's an illusion. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within.
She can't go in there.
A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Truth says there's always another route. Find a way, Senua. Go round, Senua. Find your own path. There's a different way.
Say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree for food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Odin wished to drink from this spring.
Reminds her of someone.
The forest.
Where? Which forest? Forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left the wilds.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own
darkness. Did she beat the darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
She should be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness and murdered her.
But she didn't work. She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
The Northmen say that Odin has two ravens. Their names are Thought and Memory. And each day, he sends them out to fly all across the world. Upon their return, they perch on his shoulders and tell him everything they have seen and heard. In this way, he learns.
Gate is open.
Open.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. Snake doesn't want to kill me. Yet, your lord, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion? Before her time comes.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion. Face him in his keep. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together. Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua. Listen, I will tell you the tale of a man called Findan. The Northmen captured Findan's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. Into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times. I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in,
strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom. Drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua, take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
Where's he going? You're winning.
It spoke.
Valravan, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.